Okay, thoughts on how to download and install Streamlit. Streamlit is an open source library of Python kwa ajili ya kufanya artificial intelligence, data science, machine learning, deep learning, statistics, social science, lakini pia kwa ajili ya kufanya operational research. Leo katika hii video episode, tutaona how to download, install and start a new project of Streamlit. Streamlit ni library kwa ajili ya kudevelop data application, website kwa ajili ya kuvisualize data, kuvisualize output, okay? So step number one, download Python. So tutakuja katika Google search engine hapo, kisha nita download Python. So nitaandika hapa Python, okay, download kwenye search engine ya Google, kisha nita click enter, okay? Then tutakuja kuklik hii hapa, first link, download Python, okay? So nita just click, good. So unaweza kuchagua hii hapa download Python, hii ni current version, so click it. Okay, so now good. So kuja kucheck hapa Python current ina download. Okay. So after downloading Python, now utakuja kufanya installation ya Python. Utakuja kwenye directory ya downloads ambapo ume download Python, for example, download directory. Kisha utakuja kuclick executable file hii hapa Python, okay? So uta double click kwa ajili ya kufanya installation. Okay? So mimi nimesha fanya installation, so for you uta click install, okay? Then make sure umecheck hizi zote, uta click next, then uta check everything hapa, everything uta just check everything, okay? Then kumbuka ku add path to environment variables hapo, na kwenye uta check, kisha uta click install, okay? So for me tayari nimesha fanya installation. After Python installation, kinachofuata ni ku check Python whether is installed. So utakuja hapa katika desktop start button, kisha utaandika cmd. Cmd ni command prompt, then click it. Good. So hapa uja kucheck Python version. So nitajust kuandika Python then space, then hyphen, okay, then version, then click enter. So now you can see my Python version is current version ambayo ni hii hapo. After then utakuja ku verify whether pip is installed. Pip is the command ambayo tuna install as a Python library. So ni file ambayo ipo kwenye Python. So nita just kuandika pip space, okay? Then hyphen, then version. Okay, then click enter. Okay, so now so ndio ya kucheck my pip version is version 24, okay? So another step is to install Streamlit library, okay? So tumia pip command ambayo ni hapa, okay, kwa ajili ya kuinstall Streamlit. Now pip space install space Streamlit, okay. After doing so, click enter. Okay, so after clicking enter, now you can see mimi nimeshafanya installation, na wewe ukuta hii requirements already satisfied, kwa nini? Kwa sababu nimesha install. Another step is to verify whether Streamlit is installed. So uta close current command prompt and open another command prompt. Utakuja katika desktop start button, kisha utaandika cmd, good. Cmd ni hii hapa, kisha uta just click, good. After clicking hapa, nitakuja ku verify whether Streamlit is installed. So utaandika Streamlit space hyphen then version, and then click enter. Now good. Ina take time kuweza ku display Streamlit version. So my current version is version number 1, okay? Streamlit version. Okay, after doing so, another step is to start a new Streamlit project, data application project, okay? So hapa kwenye directory ya downloads, nita right click, okay? Then ta choose new, then ta create a new directory. Okay, so directory name is my project. Okay, my project. Then double click to open my new directory. Njoo hapa katika directory address bar hapa. Just click it kwa highlight. Then futa kilichopo andika just cmd. Okay. Write cmd, then click enter. So here we start a new Streamlit application. Then kinachofuata ni kufungua command prompt, kufungua Visual Studio Code. So hapa nitafungua Visual Studio Code kwa kutumia cmd. Nitaandika code space dot forward slash, then click enter. Good. Now Visual Studio Code ina run na current ona inafunguka, okay? Okay, so now good. Hii ni Visual Studio Code na imefungukia kwenye my directory ambayo ni hii, my project. Okay. Another step is to start a new file. New file, file Python. So hapa hapa naoja hapa kwenye hii hapa kwa ajili ya ku create a new file kwenye this icon. Icon hii inatumika ku create a new file. Hii inatumika ku create a new folder. Hii inatumika ku refresh. So hapa nita just click new file. So file name is M capital letter main. Okay? Then dot file extension dot py. Dot py file extension ya Python. Kisha nita click enter. Good. Now hapa nita import pandas. Nita import any Python library unaweza ukaimport. So for now tuna just print hello world. So import, so yes, import stream rate, choose stream rate. Okay, as st, he just import is keyword, stream rate is Python library, is st is alias. Okay, so tatumia now st. Okay, so now we just put something, for example st ambayo ni hii hapa tumeimport dot dot what dot title st dot title. Now for example here hapa ni widget, title is a widget ambayo inatumika ku display a title. Now inapitisha a string data type humo ndani na the string data type. So welcome, for example, welcome. Welcome to data app. Okay, welcome to data app. You can just see a title and st dot, for example, subheader. Okay. For example, now machine, okay, learning. Now, after doing so, hapa kuliko katika file, then save changes. Then run our application. Ku run your application kwenye hii Visual Studio Code, una click terminal, then choose new terminal. Okay, choose new terminal now, ukija huku chini ita just ku expand. Okay? Ukija kukuta hii hapa kwa ajili ya ku start our application, ku run our server. Okay, so hapa tupo kwenye directory ya downloads. Okay, my project kwa kutumia Visual Studio Code. Okay, so nita just kuandika hapa stream rate then space then run space. Our file is main.py, na mimi naandika main is case sensitive, M capital letter main.py. Okay, after doing so and click enter kwa ajili ya ku execute. Okay, so now wait a moment, na inafungua katika hii hapa. So our server is currently online, na this is the IP address, inafungua kwenye this IP address. Okay, and this is the port number. So current server yetu na run kwenye hii port number. Okay, so sometime utakuwa prompted kwa ajili ya kuingiza email address. So ukiwa prompted kuingiza email address, enter your email address. Okay, so now copy this IP address, copy it, or you can click. So kuja hapa unabonyeza tu hapa click. Okay, good. So run again. Now good. So hii hapa IP address ambayo tumepewa, unaweza ka click. So follow link kwa ku click, then open. Good. So now you can see welcome to data app. This is machine learning. Okay, and now you can see this is an IP address, class IP address of our server, and this is port number ambayo ina run your stream rate. Okay, so naweza ka add more functionality. So nitakuja hapa juu, nita set page configuration. Now ukiangalia kuangalia hii hapa ina just kuonekana at the center, so tunataka tuifanye iwe kwenye hali ambayo kwamba ni full width. Okay, so nakuja hapa nitaandika st dot set hapa, set page configuration, then just like hapo layout width. Okay, So hii layout kwa ajili ya kuset width. Nikitaka kujua kinachofuata hapo mbele yake, nabonyeza control keypad kwenye keyboard na I hold, kisha nabonyeza backspace. Now you can see number of arguments, centered or wide or any. So I choose wide. Okay. After choosing wide now, and then save changes. And then refresh and output. Refresh and output. Now you can see page is full width. Now tunakuja kuweka hii hapa side navigation. Side navigation takuja hapa, okay? Andika just st dot sidebar, or you can say width st dot sidebar, okay? St dot sidebar. Hapa nitaweka hii hapa a colon, okay? Then st dot just header, okay? Then dashboard, for example, dashboard, okay? So now save changes, then click file and save changes. Good. So currently our server in a run, okay? So njoo kwenye here our web browser, then refresh. Now good. Now you can see hii ni side navigation ambayo tumecreating, na hii hapa ni dashboard. So niki close na kuna hii niki. Now hii hapa ni just kwenye upande wa right side kwa ajili ya kufanya setting ya page how it look. Niki click, ta click settings, okay? Kwenye settings hapa unaweza ku choose a theme. Theme now you can choose a dark. So niki choose dark, now you can see how ina look, okay? Au unaweza kaja hapa kwenye settings, okay? Nikaja ku choose a theme, nita click. Sorry. Nitakuja hapa katika theme, nitakuja ku click hii hapa, okay? Nitakuja ku choose hii hapa use system setting, na itarudi kwenye default ambayo ni hii. Okay? Good. Now kwenye next video episode tutakuja ku check how to start a development kwa ajili ya ku create a Streamlit application.